So let's start the session. And this is the data analysis session. We have three speakers in this session: Anand Sen Gupta, Archana Pai, and Sanjeev Mitra, who will talk on various things. And I'll just tell you what they'll talk about, basically. So types of gravitational wave sources and search methods. So I'll just show a few slides to the thing, and we'll be off. So there are different types of gravitational wave sources. The most which is celebrated one, because in so many years now, 3 years, we have been seeing this. Compact binary coalescences, black holes, or neutron stars. Those are the sources. They go around each other, emit gravitational waves, and we detect them. Then there are burst sources like supernova. Then there are stochastic. There's a stochastic gravitational wave background produced by unresolved gravitational wave sources. Supernova core collapses, black hole mergers, R modes, LMXVs, whatever. What have you. But here the waveforms are not well modeled, and so the search methods have to be different. And then there are continuous wave sources like asymmetric rotating neutron stars, like the LMXPs, things in LMXPs. And the most, I think the source which has been most studied, I think, is SCO X1. I think we have one of the experts here. Chris Messenger. But I think there are three speakers, and there will be the first three things will be covered. Unfortunately, the CW sources are not being covered. Maybe you can, I don't know, in some session. So then we have types of signals. So signals with parameterizable waveforms. So those are the compact binary coalescences. There are parameters there, continuous wave sources. There also there are parameters, direction, whatever, could be spin down parameters and things like that. Then stochastic background, it could be astrophysical or cosmological. And there are unmodeled sources like burst and transients and so on. And the techniques depend on the type of source. So for compact binary coalescences, we have this, when we know the waveform quite well, so there is this method of match filtering where we follow the phase of the signal. Then there are burst sources, which use basically time frequency methods are used. For continuous wave signals, there can be Fourier transforms, short Fourier transforms, and so on. Doppler spin down after spin down corrections, or cross correlation methods. Different time segments from the same detector or different detectors are cross correlated, and then you get you can build a large enough SNR above the threshold. And the last one is the stochastic background, where you have optimally weighted cross-correlated data from independent detectors. So you cross-correlate data from different detectors. And since the noise is independent, but the signal is not, you would get some kind of a signal. So now I'll pass over to the panelists. So Anand Sen Gupta, he will talk about compact binary coalescences and match filtering.